Hey, Fairy Duster, Fairy Ranch Fairy here. I got a triple fairy duster of when things sort of go right, but they go right after they go wrong. Does that make sense? Yeah, it makes sense. Stay tuned, triple fairy duster. Right, this has been super popular and I'm getting a lot of submissions, and I'm sorry if I don't get to you. I'm trying to post stuff on Instagram, on my channel, and give everybody props. I'm getting to the fairy dusters. You know, hang in there, folks. If you send them, keep sending them. I'm trying. Anyway, I've got three cases of when things don't go exactly perfect, but you still get your deer relatively efficiently. And this is this comes out of my arrows jumping the string. So I have a video called Fletching Noise and Arrows Jumping the String. And I don't know that anyone on YouTube is researching the fact that you're not going to hit where you're aiming. You better just guarantee that. Sometimes it works, but we're seeing a lot of deer jump and do crazy stuff. And when you shoot adult arrows, it works out. So the first guy up is Seth Winkle. He shoots 50 pounds, woo, and a 612 grain arrow. He's running the Maasai red line. And he shot a doe, and he kind of center masked it, right? It just twitched, or he made a mistake. It's one of those weird hits, and she didn't run. It zipped right through her, and she was just like, well, I don't know what I'm going to do now. And she laid down right in front of him. And he said, well, heck, if she's going to lay there, I'm going to zing her again. So he shoots her. She's laying on the ground right between the shoulder blades, and the broadhead pops out her sternum, and that worked. She got up and ran away from him, but it was an easy recovery, you know, not very far. They let her go for like an hour, just being responsible, and didn't have trouble getting her. So when you're shooting adult arrows and the angles get weird and the animals react, or you make a mistake, the thing we're seeing is these arrows are so efficient. They just zip through and the animals don't really panic after you shoot them. And then secondarily, if you got to shoot them again, you can shoot them anywhere. So 50 pounds, 612 grains, arrow hits near the spine and pops out the sternum. That's pretty lethal and handy when you have adult arrows. Next up, all right, Mr. Wilson. He set up the ranch very special. He got a 300 spine arrow, got a heavy insert, and shooting the 125 grain Black Hornet. Shooting at a deer that's supposed to stand still like a 3D target when you're shooting with your fat friends on Thursday. And you're the best shot ever. Unfortunately, the deer had other plans. This deer spun so hard that the broadhead hit it in the chin, went down the side of its face, slipped up under the spine, and ran off. And it was not an easy recovery. It took a while. Fortunately, you know, in certain ways, it's good that the deer was cut across the face, because he said the blood was sprayed up high on the really thick cover they had to go through. But the arrow still had enough velocity and mass to drive in under the spine and catch the top of one lung and probably sever the aorta. This is not predictable. He wasn't trying to shoot a deer in the face. It just jumped so hard that it got in the way, got dinged, and then the arrow still worked out. So it's another crazy story of stuff you can't predict. Good job, Mr. Wilson. I haven't done that one yet. I don't know that I'll plan to, but that is a cool story. All right, last but not least, we have Eric. He's shooting 700 grains and the 190 grain meathead single bevel, which is just one of the most efficient heads I've ever shot. Long and narrow and deathly. 708 grains. So we've all been in a tree or in a hunting situation where you're at full draw and you get busted. And that's what happened with this doe. You know, under 20 yards, deer looks up, gotcha, And he said, man, if this stuff works, let's find out. He held low on the shoulder and turned it loose. She jumped so hard. Here's a picture of the impact point. The deer jumped so hard that the arrow entered basically on top of the shoulder, right next to the neck. And it didn't know it hit anything. It exited back in the low in the stomach. Here's the exit wound. He took a couple of interior photographs. So he got a lung. And then look at these cuts in the liver. That's a, you know, barely just a little over an inch. It's an inch wide broadheads. And everybody's like, well, no, broadheads don't cause any damage. Those are pretty significant lacerations. Easy recovery. We don't want to work too hard at this. Another example of missing by 10 inches because the deer jumpy and you're at full draw and you got to turn it loose. You know, you don't see that with the old flappers. They hit that spot and they bounce off or they explode and you don't get your deer and you're sad. So three examples again of situations that you get in where the deer alter your impact point and things get in the way that you think you can't blow through or you can't predict things happening that get crazy and then the arrows still work out. And they all went wrong, but they all went right. So there ain't nothing better than the ranch fairy having people be happy. Hey, send your fairy duster pictures and stories in. I'm going to do my best to get to everybody. Like I said in the beginning of the video, this has been super popular. It is super fun to give props to the ranch fairy nation and all the fairy dusters out there. I don't know anybody else on YouTube who's saying, hey, man, you know, what I'm doing's working. And then giving props to all of their fans out there. It's super cool. It's very rewarding to have a channel where you do research, set stuff up, help people build arrows, talk all spring and, you know, through the summer. And then they come rolling in. It's just a great thing. And we don't want any losses. We want to be as effective as we possibly can. Snort the fairy dust. Hit subscribe. You might learn something. Ranch Fairy out.